Thank you all so much. So while I was down there, I was staying with Mub and Papo, and I had a room, you know, back in the corner of the house, and there's a light right outside of my window, and bugs would fly all around that light. It was real hot down there and humid. Bugs love that. So they were all flying around outside of the light, and there were, you know, little frogs that stick to the window. And one night there was four frogs stuck to the window, and one of them only had three legs, and I figured that little dude probably had a hell of a story if anybody could get it out. And, he didn't seem like he could read or write, so I decided to make him his own story. It's called Four Frogs. Rather uncharacteristically, I'm not gonna say too uncharacteristically. I do covers every now and then, but most of the time we're not so cover happy. tonight we're going to go ahead and do one. It's a Bob Dylan cover. It's called You Ain't Going Nowhere. Three more songs, we're gonna rename the show. So I don't like to confess a lot of things on stage, but I will go ahead and say that I've got a problem with putting too much money in the jukebox at a lot of different beer joints. I happen to do that. If you got a jukebox, hit me up on Facebook Messenger or something. I'll come load that thing up. I do love to hear the song that I want to hear at that moment and only right then. And this song is kind of born out of one of those moments. I felt like I just had to hear a certain song and went up to play it. And for the first time in my life, a jukebox told me there was too much money in it to accept any more cash. So I figured I had to write a song called Too Much Money in the Jukebox.
Our sound guy, George, must have read the sweat on our face. He is kind enough to turn on fans. Yeah, George. Thanks for making us sound good and feel good.
Hey, George, didn't I ask you for one of them fans to be right here to blow my hair back? I thought we talked about this before the show. Whatever. Well, you know my loss. Yeah, totally. Swear. So we got a whole slew of new songs, and we figured we're gonna get some of them right out of the way pretty quick, on account of that's just it's better taste, you know. That way you can finish strong if you happen to. I don't believe we're gonna though, but I feel like we kind of got this thing. This one's called "Hot Damn," and I wrote it here in the past couple months because that's kind of the way I felt. So.
Yeah, hot damn.
Cool. So I was having a hard time finishing a song that I'd had for years, and I talked to Junior about it for just a minute, and he had just the right words for it and finished the third verse. And you know, truth be told, I was ready to just give up on the song because I felt kind of stupid starting a song off about like pickup lines or something, but somehow Junior made it all right, so.
He failed to realize that there's people in this world that are real good at bad pickup lines.
And strength in numbers and those kind of things too is real. And when there's a whole lot of bad pickup lines at one time, maybe, you know, it's called the shotgun effect. And just one of them might work. And it's, yeah. We gotta talk about what else we got, because we're about to start repeating songs here in a minute. I'm kidding. We got a couple more, at least three.
Was that cool we played first?
We're going to do this cover here. It's by a little band called the Box Tops. They were a hell of a band to be playing at the time they did, and I hear this a meaningful song to a lot of people, so we keep playing it.
Yeah.
Proud to play it up here.
Yeah.
time for no fast train. As long as the days are gone, I'm a going home, my baby. Now she wrote me a letter. One more together, and then you want to do one, and then we'll take a break?
Yeah, I'll do one. Yeah.
So we got three more before the break, but or no.
Two more.
Before.
We'll get our math figured out eventually.
I went to public schools, a good one, but.
Well, I went to public school, but I'm not going to call a good one.
He still can add. That's all on me, I guess, guys. This one here is called...
Don't you know you're the logistics of this operation? Yeah, let's do it.
Let me show my sensitive side, Junior.
All right.
I got the sensitive side. And I wrote this song in the shower. It was the very first song that I ever wrote without a guitar with me. And I kept around. I was in Charlotte. And it was really cool. I was really proud of myself for figuring that out, and so I think that's part of why it stays around. And don't ever let anybody tell you not to sing in the shower, because it's number one, really fun, and also cathartic. So. I could blame alcohol, but it just ain't her fault. Blues again. Eric Jr. Ledford, though.
Yep. So I'm going to thank you, Mr. Hunter. I want to end our set here with one more song. And this is another slow song. I'm sorry, guys. I'm going to do it to you again. But I wrote this song about a good friend of ours. His name is Brandon and his lady Angelica. And I don't know how many of you are Black Mountain local, but a few years ago we had that party. The Party Rock fire, that whole forest fire situation up on Highway 9. I wrote a song about that. The leaves are starting to fall and it's getting cold. Ain't seen right in my mom's soul. When we up the valley, fast and wild. Damn, no mother nature set the mountain on fire. These dark skies and high walls. Like no one in this town ever seen before. You can see the smoke rise as the flame went high. Damn, no mother nature set the mountain on fire. Oh. taking back God's creature like it was something we owed him. You could hear the ambulance and the fire trucks rolling like a combo sour. Damn, no mother nature set the mountain on fire. Fireman can't get to him, can't tread the terrain. So they're bringing him buckets and big and plain. He's trying to contain the flames and wow. Damn, no mother nature set the mountain on fire. Cause we don't know if this whole place is burning down. Rolling through the mountain like a destructive locomotive. Flames of hell taking back God's creature like it was something we owed him. You can hear the ambulance and the fire trucks rolling like a combo siren. Damn, Mother Nature set the mountain on fire. Said, damn, no Mother Nature set the mountain on fire.
Thanks, y'all. We'll be right back.
Oh, I think we're on now.
We on. We can go ahead and do this thing.
No, so it is.
No, I turned it back up.
Can I make it more awkward and just kind of face y'all while I play this song?
I'm not
Junior's gonna take a hint one day.
I'm not down with the boss.
So we're gonna start this one with a little cover. I'm Hunter Begley and this is Junior, Eric. Junior Ledford over here to my stage right, to my right, and we're real happy to play a song that's near and dear to me and a couple other people in this room, and it's a fun one. So
we're at the right spot.
Get drunk and I sure do dread it, cause I know just what I'm gonna do. Gonna spend my money calling everybody honey and I'll wind up singing the blue. Spend my whole paycheck on some old wreck, brother, I could name you a few. But I gotta get drunk. gonna do. Gonna spend my money calling everybody, honey, and oh, I love singing the blues. Spend my whole paycheck on some old wreck. Brother, I could name you a few. Well, I gotta get drunk and I sure do. Daddy told me, know just what I'm gonna do. Who wrote that song, but he's a pretty cool dude, right? Whoever that was, I'll be darned. This next one here is called Key of C. I don't really have to say who wrote that song, or at least who played it. I actually couldn't tell you who wrote it. That's a good point. This next one's, do you think Willie wrote it? He might have. We'll give it to him. We'll give it to Willie. Can we all just give it to Willie real quick? Yeah, let's just give him a round of applause anyway. Because he's kind of the man, and we just want to send him good vibes wherever he's at, because we know he could use it right now.
Yeah.
This is called Key of C, and there's another song here.
Oop. Take it away.
Troubled mind. And what I have is a willful and stubborn side. It's a willful and stubborn side. Got a willful and stubborn side. And what I need, I have. What I need, I have. So what do I need? What do I need? What do I need? All right. If y'all come by the town pump and I happen to be working there on a Saturday, and you order a shot of Wild Turkey 101 and I have my guitar, I will play you this song. It's a little thing that I've been doing for a while now, and only so many people know about it, but this song is called Whiskey Dick. I think all the children are outside. We're good. So. Sorry, folks. All right, here we go.
Who?
I forgot to tell him. Sorry, Craig.
I don't get it.
I'll tell him next time. We'll get it. Earmuffs.
Let's go.
This happens ever so often, and I'll always let y'all know when it happens, because I'm shamelessly here and telling you, I'm trying to remember the words right now, and I'll get it just this next second. Let's just all share this together. It's a very uncomfortable moment for me, and it'll get more comfortable as we share it together, and the words will come to me because of that, probably. Let's see.
With an empty fountain pen.
So there's this one time I had a little album release, and it was here because there's a lot of awesome people who made that happen, and so we released it, and there was a human who showed up and said that there was the reason that I wrote all the songs that were on the CD. And that wasn't true, and that kind of upset me that I didn't even have a voice in that. So I wrote a song that would decide if this person would claim all the songs I wrote about them or just the convenient ones. And this is called The Mean Song.
Let's play it.
He called it the meanest song he'd ever wrote. I was just like, well, mean song really just fits.
It's the meanest song I ever wrote to anybody. And there it is. Good at grammar or poetic arts. Well, we sang karaoke and she missed all the parts. She sucks to play pool with, she's shitty at darts. But she's pretty damn good about breaking my heart. Her forehead's too big and her cheeks are too fat. Well, her ass is too wide and her chest is too flat. Her eyes are too beady and too far apart. But she's pretty damn good about breaking my heart.
She's pretty damn sure that I wrote her this song.
Thank you, man. I can't even remember it all the way. I tried to forget, block it out. Right, I'll tell you what. We decided a really fun way to do this was to do one called Whiskey Dick, and then Mean Song, and then Life is Hard. Somehow poetically worked for the set list. So here we are. I'm a country boy, true through and through. Stubborn, I can old dying mule. My folks say shouldn't drink so much. Hardly off of that turtle stuff. My heart's broke. That's all smoke. My chuck's dead in the yard. Life is hard. Made my mama cry just a little bit. Cause I raised some hell and got a shovel shit. I got some. I could only learn how to love myself. My heart's broke. That's all smoke. My truck's dead in the yard. Life is hard. Well, I'd like to send a message up to Uncle Sam. But I really don't think he's gonna give a damn. Tell him I'm choking, running out of rope, and I'll meet him at the bar. So when I lived in Louisiana for that little time there, I decided to write a song that was kind of giving directions to where I lived. And I didn't get very far in the directions where I just caught a tangent, and if you know me, I'll do that. But this song's called Big Rig on account of that.
Grip on my heart. bush. I pulled the walls in mud. I feel like sand after something you touched set me free. Girl, I need you always here with me. If the stars in my eyes are empty, let it ride. If the song in your heart is distant, well, don't make a sign. If the way you're feeling for me expires, it makes your tears fall off.
I just didn't want to stop it. He was ready, but I was just still rocking and rolling, man. That's like a big rig, isn't it, somehow?
Brakes take a while to work. Back to Mr. Hunter Begley.
No. You don't get off that easy. Go ahead and give him a round of applause for playing some awesome, awesome deep metal blues. How about Antiques Roadshow, like it is?
Yeah.
All right. I'm about to do one called Antiques Roadshow that... if I don't break a sweat doing this one, I probably shouldn't be here right now. I like this song. I'd also like watching Antiques Roadshow, and it's really served me well with my digital antenna and PBS. That stuff's awesome. If y'all don't have one of them, it's just kind of good cheap entertainment that is very educational, and I support that. So anyhow, there's my little plug for PBS. Support, enjoy. All right, here we go. This is called Antiques Roadshow.
Thank you.
the first post, so good luck with me. Seemed like it was up and done pretty good. Hey, Melissa, you just guess what was under the hood. I couldn't keep a moving with you after school, so I walked a little slow and you thought I was cool. Lucy didn't take a bit of fooling from me, and I still remember Jackie was attempting to sing. Oh, you know you.
So this next one right here, I'm really excited to play this one. Thank you very much, Kate. I do want to play this. It's called Wild Tim the Tornado. And it's a new song that I'm so proud of, this little song right here. Please don't laugh at me. I'm gonna be singing a lot of words. This fan's supposed to be blowing my hair back. That, Jim, it. Still waiting on the fan blowing the hair. So I guess I'll tell y'all a little bit about this. I was headed up to it. So I do this ever so occasionally, and I hope I don't do it tonight. I'll leave places and forget to get paid for the gig we do. Also, if you're a booking agent that's here, you know, there's a 50-50 shot. We might not even ask you for payment. I might just
how much time we spend at the bar, you might luck out.
you might just get that for free. So book us, you know.
We're here.
I can still hear you. all right. You know, all right, sweet. So here we go. This is Wild Tim the Tornado.
Let's kill it.
Wild Tim the Tornado, still waiting for his train to come. He's sitting at the station, shut down since he was There's no one left in his hometown with the chickens and the bombs. The only thing they do is ask them new folks where they're from. Oh, he ain't breaking out of here, he's just baking in the sun. Sitting on a suitcase, staring down the tracks and waiting for his train to come. Tim the tornado, he was born on a peaceful day. His mom and daddy loved the world, they raised their boys that way. Yeah, the youngest one was little Sam, the piano child was Tim. Yeah, everything was perfect back before the wind blew in. At first it stirred the sand, then the house came off the ground. No one found the bodies, but the roof flew clear to town. Somehow two young brothers lived and mom and daddy died. Tim held on to little Sam, but neither young and cried. They got split up heading back to town in two white vans. Tim lost his little brother when the wind came back again. Twister yet, just weird and wild and broke. They liked him when he sang his songs, despised him when he spoke. There was only one around who even fancied how he looked. Well, she was kind of broken too, her mama named her Brooke. Well, that was back before she tried to toss her under plow. That's another story, more than we got time for now. But Tim and her was getting on real well there for a while. Poor boy's forehead tight and he came real close to smiling. He was zipping up his pants, there came a rustle through the trees. From then on, Tornado Tim believed wind comes in threes. Shut down since he was young. There's no one left in his hometown but the chickens and the bums. He ain't asking nobody where they're from. He's Wild Tim the Tornado. Man, he's baking in the sun. Sitting on a suitcase, staring down the tracks, just waiting for his train to come. Tornado, he's sitting on his luggage box. Got a three-piece suit, a feathered hat, and them keyed piano socks. His knuckles turned as white as bone, knees shaking in his slacks. When he finally heard that rumble coming down the railroad tracks, the ground beneath his feet began to tremble and to quake. A 1940 penny on the rail began to shake. His hat flew off, his hair blew back, and Tim lost all his breath. Well, just ahead, that roaring train was swirling winds of death. Everything he had, including his own earthly form, was swept away to nothingness, that black from which he come. He took that final train ride, you know, the one that never ends. That wind don't mind the rule of threes, just ask Tornado Tim. Woo-hoo. listen, here's it's a slow song.
Hey, is that the best you can do?
Hey, I'll tell you what, bud. It's definitely a lot of fun
hey,
here.
Hey, takes your right.
Thank all y'all for digging this.
Way.
And
now I can see you. Hi.
Eric Jr. Ledford over here. Let's give him a hand. He's the man. Absolutely tearing it up tonight. This one here is called Sometimes Like Rain. Sometimes like rain, you come rolling down. As long as there's deep blue pain, you'll be around. I know you don't miss me much as yourself, but you got your whiskey from somebody else. It's love down the drain. As hard as I try, chops on the sidewalk, falling down as I cry. Sometimes like rain, like rain. So I like to write these little ballads and things too that are, I write a lot of like about my own life and stuff, and that gets kind of taxing. So every now and then I like to write one that's totally about nothing in the world close to me, and this is one of those. It's called Sunday Service and is pretty good time for me to play, and Junior's one who can rip this song up, so let's do this one here, right?
I like this one a lot.
Hotter than oven on the Mississippi River, running steamboats in mid-July. When I thought I had enough working on the muddy river, went looking for a place to hide. Fooled around and found myself caught up in the middle of a woman and a terrible call. I was sleeping with the wife and mother of her children, and she was sleeping with the law. Singing la-di-ya-di-yo-di-yo-yeah, sir, I'd kill that man someday. Oh, good God, it's the price we pay.
I just realized that the next song I have is also in A minor, so we're gonna skip that one. Like I said, I didn't have to tell y'all none of that. I just went on ahead. That was on the set list, and now we're not doing that one.
We'll do it later.
That's a cool sound, but it's ominous. Should we try and work with it? Like, man, that's a loud noise coming from right there. He said you should hear it from outside. It's a little perspective joke there. Sarah, I think you should know. You're the one I'm thinking of when I'm all alone and feeling low. Bobby wasn't my friend. I swear I'd take your hand and show you things you ain't seen before. But what do you say in moments like this? What should I do with a girl who looks like you? Well, I'll be God damn. Right. Oh man, this is bad. Situation I'm in, but I got myself into it. I'm gonna get me out, I'll be dead blamed.
That's another good one too.
If she wasn't my friend, where I'd take her hand and show her things she'd never seen before. What do you say in moments like this? And what should I do with a girl who looks like you?
I think he's gone. No! Ah, oh, come on!
Thinking you're beautiful, even when your hands are full of dishes working at the restaurant. I came just to see you, and I'll be on PBS singing my songs. Where it won't take too long, I'll be with you, my friend.
Pretty close. We've been trying to figure out a radio-friendly version of that song for some time now, and nothing's really clicking yet. If you have any ideas, text me. We're taking suggestions.
Will you be around? Can I call you when you do? Or are you about to head out? Until at least 9.
We do like to cover this one certain person here.
more than others on account of he's just, number one, a really cool dude. Far as I can tell, I've never met him, but I saw him from afar one time, and from that distance he seemed really cool. So here's Mamas Don't Let Your Babies Grow Up to Be is it Caballos?
Cowboys.
Caballos. Cowboys ain't easy to love, man, they're harder to hold. They'd rather give you a song than diamonds or gold. Lone Star bell buckles and old faded Levi's, each night begins a new day. If you don't understand him, he don't die young. You'll probably just ride away. Mamas, don't let your babies grow up to be cowboys. Don't let them pick guitars and drive in old trucks. Let them doctors, lawyers, such. Mama, don't let your babies grow up to be cowboys. They'll never stay home, they're always alone. Even
let them be doctors. doctors, lawyers, such. Mamas, don't let your babies grow up to be cowboys. Cause they'll never stay home, they're always alone, even with someone they love.
We're gonna do one more together, and then Junior's got a whole handful of songs that he's just very proficient at, and is going to show y'all what he's got. He's a heck of a musician, so here we go.
Hunter's gonna sing this one though.
First thing I remember knowing was a lonesome whistle blowing and a youngin's dream growing up to ride. On a freight train leaving town, not knowing where I'm bound, no one cleared my mind, but mama tried. Born an only rebel child, with a family meek and mild, my mama seemed to know what lay in store. Despite all my Sunday learning, with the bat I kept on turning till mama couldn't hold me anymore.
I turned 21 in prison, doing life without parole. No one could steer me right, but mama tried, mama tried, mama tried to raise me better, but her pleading I denied. That leaves only me to blame, cause mama tried.
Tried to raise me right, but I refused.
And I turned 21 in prison, doing life without parole. No one could steer me right, but mama tried, mama tried, mama tried to raise me better, but her pleading I denied. That leaves only me to blame, cause mama tried. Tried, mama tried, mama tried to raise me better, but her pleading I denied. That leaves only me to blame, cause mama tried. That leaves only me to blame, cause mama tried.
Hey y'all, I'm Junior and I'm back again.
Thank you.
All right, this is one of my favorite ones to play. This is an old Ray Charles tune. You give your hand to me, and then you say hello. Never knew the heart of making
I let my chance go by. Chance that you might love me too. You give your hand to me, and then you say goodbye. I want you to walk away beside that lucky guy. Oh, you'll never, never know the one that loves you so. 'Cause you don't know me. Train will come in, coming around the bend. I ain't seen the sunshine since I don't know when. Lord, I've been looking for some prison. I keep dragging on. I hear that train coming, I hang my head in the moon. Mama told me, son, always be a good boy. Don't ever play with guns. But I shot the man in Reno just to watch him die. I hang my head in this prison. Hang my head and cry. Folks eating on them fancy dining cars. They're probably drinking coffee and smoking Mexican. Well, I know I had to come in. No, I can't be free. That train needs moving. They freed me from this prison, and that railroad train was mine. You bet I'd move in for the little
Thank y'all so much.